In this video, I will tell you everything you need to know to get started with Google Slides. Number one, create a new presentation. To create a new Google Slides file, head over into Google Drive. In this case, I'm in My Drive. I've created a Project DOM folder and I simply right-click, hover over Google Slides, and then choose from a template. My Drive, by the way, is the only place where you can save Google Slides files. So since I am using Google Workspace on our organization, we have our own organization template gallery. That's what we find here under saperis. So if I wanted to create a file, a presentation based, let's say on this here, I simply click on it once, it will create a new presentation based upon this template that we have on our organization. Now, with any Google account, be it a Google Workspace or also a free Google account, you will also have, and let me go back to the template gallery, a free template gallery, which you will find under General. As said, if you have a free account, you will see this too. As a matter of fact, it will be the only template gallery you see. Now I'm going to close this out and I'm going to create a new blank presentation. I do so by simply clicking here on Google Slides. Have a look at this sidebar that appeared here when I created this new blank file. These are themes, predefined themes that Google gives us and we can choose from. Let's say I wanted to use this. I simply click on it once and it comes complete with a lot of different layouts. So I could, for instance, add a section header. I could add a main point. It comes fixed with text boxes with that I are editable, that I can just go ahead and add my content like so. If I'm not happy with that theme, I can choose any other theme. And once I've chosen my theme, I think it's best to close this sidebar out like so and just go ahead and add my content. Number two, add and edit content. So the very first step before actually adding your content is naming your presentation. So let's call this the Project DOM slide deck, like so. By the way, renaming, you can just click in the name. So on the untitled, just click in that or file and there should be a rename here. Yeah, there you go. Rename if you prefer that way. I'm guessing you want to start with some text. So I'm just going to click in here and you can see that we have the placeholder text box so that we can use. This is the title, but if we want to add more text than we have placeholders for, simply click on text box, add it like so, and extra text box. Now, obviously, this is very small, so what I can do is I can change the sizing. Oops, select it, change the sizing like so. I can directly write in this. Let's make this 30 pixels. I can change the font color, which I will find here, maybe something that's a bit better readable, like so. Okay, so that's text box. Now in any presentation, I'm just gonna go ahead and add a blank, here you go, a blank slide. You will probably want to have images. You have a couple of different sources from which you can choose images. I'm thinking the one you're gonna use predominantly is Google Drive. So any images you have saved up on Google Drive. We have a couple of random screenshots we've made here. I'm just gonna click on insert, like so. I do want to point out to another source, search the web. So let's say we're searching for the logo of Nike. Great, here's the logo of Nike. Should I add that to my presentation? Probably not. Think of copyright issues. So we're using Google search here, but we're not sure if we're actually allowed to use these images. That's why in training sessions I give, I usually say, you know, it's a great idea to be able to search and find any image on the web, but it's also a risky affair actually using that image. Good, so those were images, shapes, very straightforward. We have a couple of different shapes we can choose from. Let's say I wanted to add this shape here. I simply click on it once. I click on the slide, I drag my mouse and the shape is there. If I want to change it, customize it, here is the fill color, the border color, And you know what? Let me go ahead and give it a different colored border so that I can show you the border sizing like so. And a lot of these shapes, if you click on the three dots here, you'll find a format options. This will also give you some more control, like you can change the width, the height. In my case, it's centimeters because I have a European country in my Google account, but in your case, these might be inches. So just go ahead and play around with that. Let me add another blank slide and show you how you can add videos, because this is a bit special. So click on insert video, and now you have two places, two sources where you can choose your video from. Let's start with the last, Google Drive. I think this is the most obvious one. Anything, any video you have stored up in Google Drive and you have access to, you can add it here. Like this team meeting, this recording I made, it's a demo team meeting. I can add it like so, I can resize it. I can set up the playing options. Like for instance, if I'm in presenting mode and I come to the slide, I want this video to autoplay. That would be one thing. By the way, I do want to point out that if you add a video that is saved up in Google Drive to a presentation, and you will be sharing this presentation with other people, like giving them viewing rights on the presentation, be sure to also share the video with them, because you are only streaming the video into this presentation. You're not actually adding it or embedding it. Meaning, if you were to share this presentation with 100 people, you add a video here, but you do not share that video with those 100 people, they will not be able to see the video. So keep that in mind, that's crucial. We are also gonna add a video from the other source being, where is it? YouTube. Here we have two tabs. So the URL, so I can add the URL of the YouTube video if I have that, or I can search for it. Let's see. We wanted to search for something about Google App Script. And this is really like the equivalent of being on Google, searching for that keyword, and then simply adding the video into our presentation like so. So this is one of my videos. If you search for Google App Script, we're one of the top videos. I can just add it like so, and people can then watch it while I'm presenting. How about we add a chart to our presentation? Again, I'm just gonna add a blank slide like so. You click on insert chart and you're presented with the option of adding these chart types. Now, if you click on one of those, it will create new Google Sheets with you with dummy data, but I'm guessing more often than not, you already have a chart somewhere in a Google Sheets file and simply wanna add it here. So what we're seeing here is a list of a lot of the Google Sheets we have, and to find a specific chart, just simply go ahead and click on a file. Now let's quickly see, we have one maybe here. I click on select. It went through the document and saw there's a chart here. I click on that. I make sure that the link to spreadsheet is ticked. That box is crucial because it means that if there are changes to our source file, to our spreadsheet, we will be able to update the chart here. So that's my chart. I can resize that if I want to. I can also access the source. So there you go, open source. You can open up this file here and you will see the chart loading here. So this is the original chart from this specific file. And you know what? Let's go ahead and let's change something in our data here. So let me scroll up here. Let's say this, oh, that's the sum. So let's make this figure very, very small. That should trigger a change. Oh, you see I have some conditional formatting going on there. So that should have an effect here. I can't see it right now, but that's okay because I want to prove this fact. There was a change on our source. The update button appears. I can click on it and my chart is updated to reflect that change in the source file. And the last thing I want to show you is how you can add your speaker notes. They're down here. You can see the speaker notes here. You can go ahead and add them like so. Obviously, that doesn't make sense, but when I'm in presenting mode, I will see the speaker notes. And I'll also show you how you can maybe display your speaker notes so that you see them, but the other people don't see them. Number 3, create and arrange slides. You already saw me how to add or how I was adding new slides, so click on the arrow button, then you have all of the different layouts that are part of the theme. Just go ahead and click on it like so, or click on the new slide and it will add it like so. And if you don't need it anymore, no problem, right click, delete, like so. Maybe I want to take this and move it somewhere else, so I just grab a hold of it and drag it here. By the way, did you know that you can hide the film strip or that you can change the view? You didn't know that, did you? You can just drag it like so, wherever you want to. You can, you know what, I'm going to go back to this view because that's what you're most likely going to be using. If you right click again, you also see that you have the option to add a new slide from here. You can duplicate a slide, or you can skip the slide or unskip it. Like so. Skipping will only have an effect when you're in the presenting mode. If you've learned something new so far, how about giving us a like and leaving a comment below stating what it was that you learned. Number 4, share presentation. Now you can have up to 100 people at the same time view, edit, and comment your document. How you do that? Click on share, and then go ahead and add whomever you want to share the document with. In this case, we're going to share this document with Adam. We're going to make him commenter. We're going to say, check this out and send him the notification so that he receives an email with the direct link to this document. Number 5, collaborate on presentation. Adam received the email with Jane's comment, and he can now go ahead, open up the file. He only has commenting rights, meaning he cannot go ahead and modify anything on this presentation, but he can leave his 2 cents. So let's say he wanted to leave a comment here on this slide. He can click here on add comment. He can also right click. I'm a big fan of right clicking. This title seems a bit weird, for instance, might want to change it. And now you can at mention someone. So he's going to at mention Jane, comment on the document like so. Let's head back into Jane's view. Let's see what she sees. So first of all, she will receive an email notification, but she will also, in this case, since she's already in this presentation, directly see Adam's comment, and she can directly answer. You're right. Something like that. Reply. And she could go ahead and change this. Let's make this title better. I don't know. Something like that. And you can have a whole conversation in here, have a short chat about something specific. Once you followed up on the comment, as Jane just did, she can mark this as resolved. As a matter of fact, Adam could have marked this as resolved as well. Number 6, print and download. Okay, file, print, and then whatever printer you have, go ahead and print it out on that. It will show the box, there you go. So, you know, let's say you have this specific printer, you can change some settings here if you need to, and then just hit the print. But I'm guessing more often than not, you probably want to download this file. So again, if you click on file, download, you're presented with the option to download it as a PowerPoint document. I'm gonna do so. And I'm also gonna download it as a PDF, as I'm guessing these are the two versions or the two file formats you will most likely be using. I'm just gonna drag it right into Google Drive. So this was downloaded to the download folder of the Chrome browser. But you can take those documents and upload it into your Google Drive again if you want to store it here. So we have a proper PDF version of our file, this is the preview, and we have a PowerPoint document. Obviously, since I'm double-clicking on this PowerPoint document through Google Drive, it will open up in Google Slides, but check the label out, .pptx. This is a PowerPoint document, and were I to open it up on my computer in PowerPoint, PowerPoint would open it up and would display it pretty much as we see it here. Number 7. Give a presentation. If you click on the slideshow button, it will start the presentation mode in full screen mode. Now, some people love it. I'm not a very big fan of it for multiple reasons. That's why I'll show you how I deal with it. I just clicked on the escape button to exit this mode. I prefer the following presenter view. That is because I almost always have my speaker notes open. So I told you that I would share with you a method how you could have speaker notes and not have other people seeing what you're seeing, aka the speaker notes. So what I generally do is I have two monitors and I set up my speaker notes on the second monitor that the people do not see that I'm not sharing, for instance, in a Google Meet call. That works perfectly fine because I see the previous, the next slide, and any notes that I've added. As a matter of fact, on one of our slides, I think we had, here was our random speaker text that I've added. So I would just drag this onto my second screen. Okay, I'm gonna stay in this mode to show you the presenter toolbar, which appears when you move your mouse down to the left side of the screen. Here you can jump to the different slides that you have. You can go forward, you can go backwards. You have the three dots, so the more options that you can use. This is my best kept secret. The laser pointer. This is awesome, especially if you're sharing your screen in a Google Meet call and you want to highlight something. How you want to say, have a look at this very important image, like so. That is something that is very well visible when you're presenting in Google Meet. Speaking of presenting in Google Meet, I'm going to go ahead and start an instant meeting. I'm going to stop my presenting mode here just by clicking on the escape button. So there you go. I'm going to turn off mic and camera. From the call itself, I could go ahead and start presenting my presentation, but I want to show you this way. Click on this present to a meeting. It will recognize that you're currently in a Google Meet call. Present tab to meeting. You can choose which tab. In my case, I only have one tab currently active, and there you go. Now people are seeing that specific tab. And this, by the way, is also neat because I can have my speaker notes open, but they won't see it because I am only sharing this specific tab. So that is another way how you can use speaker notes but hide them from the participants. I have a dedicated video about presenting in Google Meet, sharing your screen, because think about it. This situation here, there's a video here. If I were just to share my entire screen, people will not hear the audio track. So check out the video. I will be linking it right now so that you don't miss out on the very important do's and don'ts. Can I ask you for a favor? Could you please subscribe to this YouTube channel? That's because I don't want you missing out on any of these video tutorials about Google Slides, Google Drive, Google Apps Script, and so on.